So I wanted to shoot a real quick video about the AK-105 front sight. I have some examples, but I just wanted to give a long shot of my conversion here. This started out life as an SLR-104 that I did the front sight conversion on. It's pretty much standard besides the CR style front sight. I'm going to zoom in here and we'll get a close-up of the three different examples I have. So here's the two pieces that I originally took off this rifle. It was a standard 104 FR, and I did get this nose cone. The barrel still is underneath here. I am going to form one it, but it still has to be 16 inches to be legal. But I cut the original gas block off. I had to cut it. I did not want to cut it. I would prefer to reuse it for another rifle, but it wasn't budging. And then this is the front sight I was able to take off cleanly and will end up on another Saiga conversion I'm doing. I've done four of these rifles so far, and they've all turned out pretty well. But let's go ahead and zoom in on these guys and we'll get started on going through the differences. Please bear with me, it's a little awkward to work around the camera, but this is a Bulgarian 105 CR style front sight. And this one up here is a Russian one. The differences are actually pretty significant, more so than you would think. If I just kind of hold this up here, stand by. The square is bigger on the Bulgarian. These are easy to find pictures of on the internet. The Russian front sight has the smaller square lightning cut. I don't know what you would call it. But there are also significant differences in the way this is constructed. If you've done a Google search for 105 front sights, you'll notice that they always say the hole for the gas port is 7 millimeters reverse of where it is on a standard barrel, and that is very true. If you look here, let's see if I can get a good shot of this without being too awkward. It is shorter, so if you look at the end of this port, it is meant to be further back on the barrel than the Bulgarian front sight. That Bulgarian front sight went on without any issues, but this would not. It would need to be moved back to line up correctly. And the diameter of this guy is smaller by 200 thousandths or whatever the official number is. This diameter for this hole is smaller. You can make this work on a standard barrel. You have to hone out this cylinder right here, or you have to shrink the barrel size by grinding it down. And if you don't want to weld up the gas port hole, you can modify this hole to be in a further forward location. It is not impossible to do, but it is challenging. It is not easy for a standard gunsmith to do. This this nose cone is actually on here, but this for the Bulgarian front sight does not have this shiny part right here. If you've seen a 106, the 223s, they're pretty easy to find. In fact, I would even say that a 223, you could buy a 106 CR and take all the parts off and make your clone. But moving on, this Russian sight is very much different. And this, even if you look at the standard locations for the detent pin and also the barrel and things like that, I can't take this one off to show you a real one, but we'll get into what this one in my left hand is here. The one in my left hand is actually a US made reproduction of the 105 front sight. It is significantly different in a couple areas that I noticed. For one, it's not chrome lined. Two, the guy I bought it from said it was nitrided. I don't know how to tell if it's nitrided. The finish is consistent. I don't know if that's bare or not, bare iron. It hasn't started to rust, but I've only had it one day. I just got it. The most significant difference I notice is the size of this material right here is a lot thinner on this US made reproduction. There is a significant difference there. I do have a front sight drum that I pulled out of another front sight I had to cut off. I converted a New Jersey rifle, AK-74. I put a normal front sight on a New Jersey rifle and I pulled the tower out of it. So it will go in here, but there's a significant difference in that amount of material right there. As far as lining it up, kind of looks pretty good. The holes kind of look like they're in the same spot. Let's see if I can tilt this camera up. You know, I think as far as physically lining up, it looks good to me. It kind of falls, I think, where it would need to be. You know, ultimately, I'm not going to know until I have another rifle to put it on, and I do not have one right now. But as far as I can tell, I think with a good paint job, this would probably make a pretty good facsimile for a 106. Even though it's not chrome lined, that might bother some people. I think there is a major difference in the size of this gas port hole right here with the standard. I can show you this. I had to hammer that a lot. Please disregard the hammer marks. That's why I ended up cutting it. So this material here is a lot thicker, so I don't know how a gas tube is going to mount on it. Ultimately, we would just have to try it and see. So hopefully if I can get a rifle to work on, we can do that. But this is a US made one. I talked to him a little bit about where he got them. He said he had them made for him. So I don't know if he's done a couple batches to bring some more into the country, because as it sits right now, the Bulgarian parts are impossible to find. And there a lot of the Russian parts did come in, but they're selling for $300 or $400. And with the amount of work you actually have to do to get these things to fit on there, it's a significant project. So I think somebody's trying to bring some of these parts in and capitalize on the fact that prices are so high. I don't know. Time will tell, but I think this is a good rundown of the different examples between the two parts, at least for video-wise, if you were at all curious about this whole setup. One of the other things I noticed between the two is that gas port hole has been drilled through that cast material. That is clear to see. If you look at that one, that's what it should look like on an AK. If you look at this one, he has obviously drilled that out. So I don't know how that would affect functionality. Seeing that, I probably wouldn't end up using this sight unless I could somehow modify it to be more comfortable with it being like that style. So that is something to note. If you do pick up one of these reproductions, be sure to check that. I'm going to give you just some close-up shots of this Russian front sight. I'll try and do it on the Bulgarian rifle as well, just so you can see some of the surfaces and the markings. I notice the angle cuts right there are a little different, and the front sight blade is a little different too. It looks thinner. There's the marking of the number 2. That's pretty standard. A lot of these have number 2s. The ones I pulled off my rifle has a number 2. This pinhole that holds the plunger is a lot different than the Bulgarian ones.